The latest jobs data has just been released today, and in June the unemployment rate rose by 0.2%. It is now 5.7%. The number of unemployed people increased by nearly 24,000. So if you're thinking about switching jobs, where are the best industries to look at? Joining us is social analyst Mark McCrindle. Hi, Mark.
Hi.
There's been an increase in part-time work.
That's so, right.
First of all, why do we think that there are more people looking for part-time work?
A lot of companies really are shifting those full-time roles to part-time roles. So full-time roles have been declining, part-time roles have been rising. I mean, you see that in the retail sector. Happy to employ some part-timers, don't want to take on the burden and the challenges of full-time employees. So a bit of a cost shifting taking place, and that made the unemployment rate look a little bit better than it could have. Perhaps a little bit of hidden unemployment there.
And more people looking for jobs too. So more people out there looking for jobs. What's this a sign of?
Well, just the household budgets are pretty tight. And maybe, you know, person number one in the household has had some hours cut back or less overtime available. So the partner is heading out to pick up some extra work as well, just to cover the costs.
Mm-hmm. Mark, we hear about jobs that get lost in manufacturing. We know retail's also doing it tough. What other sectors are struggling?
Anything with a low skill base, anything that's in the discretionary spend area is doing pretty badly at the moment. And we can't forget the small business sector. We've got 2.1 million businesses in Australia, and now 5 years on from this GFC, those small businesses are doing it tough. If you look at all of the small businesses that began in Australia 5 years ago, half of them do not exist anymore.
Wow.
Massive, a lot of blood on the floor out there in the small business world.
So they're the jobs disappearing and being lost, but where are the new jobs emerging? What sectors?
Well, look, technology certainly takes away a lot of jobs. We see that in manufacturing, a lot of jobs being offshored, but it also creates a lot of jobs. I mean, there's whole new fields there. You've got teleworking coordinators who manage people working from home. You've got the whole social media world that has emerged. You've got app developers now, you know, creating these apps for companies right around the place, cybersecurity professionals. In the medical field, medical nanotechnology
what
emerging.
What is that?
Well, it's sort of at very small levels. You know, these medical technologists can make changes, can help us out at a nano scale.
Lots of science. I'll explain more in depth in the green room.
So if somebody is watching at home and they're looking for work and they're thinking that they need to diversify, perhaps they were working in one of the fields that is really going downhill, what would you suggest that they do? Reskill?
Definitely. Look, it's not jobs for life anymore, like our parents had it. You know, you got that job 10, 20, 30 years, that's changed. It's not even career for life. We've got to keep upskilling, getting more education. Obviously, we've got to look at the technological trends so that we're not heading towards a dead end. But beyond that, look at the demographic trends. I mean, we've got record births, and so you look at childcare services growing in Australia. We've got an ageing population. So that means not just aged care jobs, but retirement services really emerging for more older Australians than ever. And also, you've just got global opportunities. Here we are on the rim of Asia, the fastest growing area demographically, and so great opportunities for us here in Australia to meet the needs up there.
So what's going to be strong? Where's somebody going to feel really safe in their employment?
Well, I think that if you have technology skills, if you're in a growth area, if you're in an area that is almost recession-proof, so it's something that we all need, it's something that's a must-have. I mean, even in a business area where it's about sales, it's about bringing revenue in, that's likely to do well. And also lifestyle areas. You know, people are prepared to pay for things we once did ourselves. A lot of those home services, the mowers and the like, even home cleaning. We're going to see more and more of that outsourcing. So if people are innovative enough, there are more jobs emerging there as well.
Do you remember the lipstick index, which is basically, it says that, you know, when consumer spending goes down, what women do is they buy lipstick because it's one small thing that you can buy that makes you feel good, but it doesn't cost as much as, you know, maybe other products or a whole bunch of things. So I guess, is that what people should do? Look at areas where, like you said, discretionary spending is down, but where do people want to, they must get a little hit. Where, you know, where is that?
Yeah, well, exactly. Look at the going out, people spending a bit more money in terms of recreation, buying out, eating out, pre-prepared meals. We're busier than ever. Lives are more complex than ever, but we're prepared to spend a little bit on some of those luxuries to make life function better. Perhaps not the luxury car, but those small luxuries, as you say, is where there's good growth.
Yeah. Mark, a lot of people say in the media game, especially to me, well, it's lucky that you've got a trade to fall back on. Do you find a lot of people are multi-skilling themselves now? So they're going into university and doing a bunch of degrees. So if something doesn't work out, they can go in the other direction.
Yeah, definitely. Multiple pathways is the way to go. And, I mean, think about those trades. If you want to do well in life, get a trade, because that's where the money is. You know, even with the technology, we still need the carpenters and the plumbers and the sparkies. So.
OK, so go into a lipstick, exports to Asia or imports from Asia. They can also mind your kids. Gotcha.
And look after yourself when you're old.
Yeah, that's right. Thanks so much, Mark.
Thank you.
We really appreciate it. Sure.